Marvin Jones was signed last offseason to make up for the loss of Calvin Johnson, and he's done exactly that, and I mean exactly. Jones's numbers through his first 23 games in a Lions uniform are nearly identical to Megatron's. Not bad for your first year with the team. Time to welcome in our friend Jack Collinsworth. Jack, Marvin has had an impressive start to the season on the field.
Those numbers are nuts, aren't they?
Not bad.
They're insane. So nobody has had a hotter start. So when you go from October to November, that little transition, the past three games, Marvin Jones Jr. has averaged 17.5 per catch on his way to 331 yards, three touchdowns. Two of those came at Lambeau Field on Monday Night Football. But as you are about to see, that's only where Marvin's talents begin.
It's audition day, baby. Who is the next American Idol? Maybe Marvin Jones.
What are you saying, baby?
Looks good, man. How you doing?
So how far back does the love for music go?
It goes back to about 94. Obviously, I was 4 years old. My dad, he was a minister at the time, kind of just put me up there in the choir. I never liked it. And so I'd be crying and stuff like that. Like, I don't want to do it. But eventually, I grew to love it.
All right, Jasmine, give me a comparison. I'm not talking about Marvin Jones, the human. I'm talking about Marvin as an artist.
I don't compare him really to anybody, but he always gets either Chris Brown or Pleasure P.
You got to take me through putting this studio. I mean, you literally put a recording studio inside your house.
Yeah. When I first got drafted, I had nothing but like a $50 USB mic and a Mac. You know, the mics, they pick up a pin drop, you know? So
yeah,
I'd be banging the music.
We couldn't walk hard, we couldn't talk, we couldn't do anything.
When we moved, the first thing I did when I looked at the house, and I went downstairs, it was an unfinished basement, and I was like, this is where my studio is gonna be. Yeah. Yes, definitely. Soundproof, so they really can't hear it like they used to.
See, I ain't been perfect, never been perfect, but this love is worth it. Maybe it's well worth the try.
Can I just say that I think that this music career, this music career thing is real, dude. Like, I feel like Scooter Braun right now.
Yeah.
I feel like I discovered you.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Like,
have the next American Idol here, Marvin Jones. Is it just me or is this thing getting real?
It's getting real, man. I'm getting excited.
How does that audition play in your brain right now?
You know, just because I've never done anything like this before, you never really know, you know, what they're gonna say first and, you know, how it's gonna go, but I just wanna go up there and start singing.
All right, baby.
Let's do it.
That's it.
Yeah.
Well, I think you go in there, it's from the heart. It's sincere, right? Yeah, they wanna see who you really are. If it comes from within right here and you're good at singing, you're gonna walk out with a golden ticket and we're gonna put you on our shoulders.
Let's do it.
Okay, buddy. Head on in there.
All right, let's do it. Oh, wrong
on
door.
Two. There you go.
Yeah.
One, two. There you go.
What's up?
What? What's up? What's up?
Hey, man.
How you doing?
Wait a minute.
You're a football player.
Yes, I am.
Wait a minute.
How y'all legends doing today?
Us?
Wait a minute.
Legends.
This is American Idol, man.
Where's the field?
This is the wrong place.
No.
This is the wrong place?
You're trying out?
Yes.
You're trying out?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
All right. So
from the locker room
to the stage, to the lights and camera. Tell us your name and where you're from.
My name is Marvin Jones Jr. I'm from Southern California, Fontana, 27.
What are you going to do for us?
I'm going to sing I Can't Make You Love Me by Tank.
I'm looking forward to it. Go for it, man.
I'll close my eyes and I won't see the love you don't feel when you're holding me. Morning will come and I'll do what's right. Just give me till then to give up this fight.
and I will give up this fight, yeah. Cause I can't make you love me if you don't. And you can't make your heart feel something it won't. Here in the dark, for these final hours, I will lay down my heart, and I'll feel the power if you won't. Oh, I can't make you love me. Oh, if you don't.
Come on, man.
The pleasure to sing it for you.
We're getting punked here.
Right. I keep waiting for the punk thing to happen, right?
Wait, why didn't you pursue music, and why did you pursue, I mean...
Because he ran a 4.3.
I know that, but like...
I could have did it early on, but I just was always playing sports, so...
So are you always singing in the locker rooms and stuff?
No, not really, but I have a studio at my house, so I do make music. So.
Yeah, do your teammates know?
No.
Mr. Jones.
Come on, Mr. Jones.
Omaha, hot route.
Come on now. It was definitely an awesome experience singing in front of the legend, one of the GOATs, and two future legends. We had a great exchange from all three of them, and it was definitely an experience to remember.
All right, so you heard what the judges said there, the new panel of judges, and we have our own panel over here. We have Randy, Simon, Paula, our own little squad. So looking like a dunk contest or something. Right, what Paula. We want you to do, it's dangerous, but we want to evaluate the singing performance of Jones Jr. Here we go.
Wait, give us a countdown. Is this our countdown? Dang, Rex!
Six.
Wow.
Hey, got the angel.
Charles.
Is that an upside down nine? Or is
wait,
that
what is happening right now?
Got a touchdown right there.
What? Is he getting a six?
Yeah.
Oh,
I don't know.
Man.
I don't know, dog. It was a little pitchy for me, dog. I mean, I'm just saying.
I watch American Idol, but I'm going to tell you what. That was courage for Marvin Jones to get up there. Kudos to Marvin Jones.
Courage don't get you picked.
I respect the honesty. You can check out the episode when it comes back. It'll be March 11th, 8 p.m. on ABC. Sam, you want to set this thing up?
Yeah, I thought that was great, though. Good job, Marvin. Okay, we're going to...
What did you give him?
I gave him a 9.
You gave him a 9?
Like,
almost 10?
I gave Katie 10. We've been working on this for a while.
Like, almost 10?
Okay, we got to take a look at Golden Tate's tweets, because we're going to take a page out of Golden's book. He's been judging celebrations all throughout the season on Twitter. It is time now for us to play judge and judge some celebrations as a team, though. It's a team sport, right, Jack? So we got to judge them based off teams. So take it away. You're a fan of white today.
Team sport. Here we go.
Fan of white.
We have the Detroit Lions.
Okay.
Up first. And so you're going to see here, this is Golden Tate. He's going to go one rope, the other rope, come back, set it up, and yeah. Drop the people's elbow on him one time. There you go. You got to love that. We have bowling. This is looking like Marvin Jones Jr. thinks it is. It's not.
Curling.
It's curling, baby. Break out the brooms and brushes one time. Get a little ice scratched off there, and now we're into ping pong. Big man wants some love. Big man wants a high five. Not going to get a midpoint. Marvin Jones Jr. takes an L. Little rock'em sock'em robots. Got to love this.
That's
looks a like
one.
A victory there. A little knockout for Jones Jr. Got him second. So we get it back to our panel here for the official score. Here we go, guys.
All right. Count us down. 1, 2, 3. Ready? Oh, tens.
No.
Charles is tough on
Yeah, I'm
people.
Tough, man.
That was great.
I think the rock'em sock'em saved him.
Yeah.
The first two people's elbow was good, but then the middle one was a little off, the curling. I'm a 7.
I just love the rock, so this is really just for the rock.
Hey, the rock is a legend.
All right, so Jack, what's up next? Good.
Here we go. That's one team down. That's the Lions. There we go. Kansas City Chiefs. Let's get it rolling. Get it cranked up. We have Tyreek Hill, house call. Going to hit him with the Joe Horn one time, dial it in. No originality points there. Only running back in the NFL over 800 yards. Don't sleep on Kareem Hunt. There you go. He's going to take a little nap in the end zone. That gets us to the potato sack portion of the evening. Across the middle there. Doing a thing. You see Alex Smith down at the bottom. You see him?
I didn't even know Alex was in there.
He's not even in the frame over there. He's not even in the frame. There you go. Tyreek Hill, only race he's ever lost in his life. Pretend or not pretend.
love it.
We got to go 3-2-1 and then score the KC team.
And I'm still going.
This is just for the potato sack. I'm with you.
I like the start of the race, how they poured the potato sack.
Yeah, you got to get in it.
Plus, you got the quarterback involved. That's not
it was all about It was all about the potato sack with that one.
You guys are the nicest judges I've ever seen. All right, Pittsburgh Steelers, let's get it rolling. Here we go. Number one, we got the Ben Schuster right here. A lot of spotters coming in. You're going to see so AB there behind.
James Harrison.
74 has no idea what's going on, so he's just going to take some pictures of it. There we go.
On social media.
Smith-Schuster chaining up that famous bike of his. Top three Twitter account in all
of the
NFL. Got to respect it. Antonio Brown, no idea what's going on. Nobody told him what to do. Look at him. No idea. Never felt more left out in his whole life. Okay, Juju on the run.
I love hide and seek. That's good.
Little classic game of hide and go seek right there.
Hey, in Antonio Brown's defense, there was always one guy that stood right by the base because you couldn't catch him. He didn't have to hide.
That's a good point. All right, 3-2-1 I'll put a number on it.
There we go.
Oh.
There we go.
Anybody around my base is automatic.
Yeah, we got automatic. Hey, love
you around.
Wait, who is the winner? Did anybody keep track?
I can tell you right there, Pittsburgh Steelers.
Breaking out of the production truck. Yeah. What do we have? 40. Oh, there we go. Steelers are the winners of Celebration Idol. You win absolutely nothing except for pride. Right?
Attaboy.
No, it doesn't? All right, awesome. Having a little bit of fun over here. Still to come on NFL Countdown, Rex tells us, if it's time to panic in Dallas, what does life, or at least six games of it, look like without Ezekiel Elliott? Plus, the longer Brady plays, the harder it is to debate that he's the all-time greatest, but is Mile High his kryptonite? The guys tell you why the altitude is so killer and why it's been such a challenge for the Patriots quarterback. Good work, Mr. Collinsworth.
No, right.
Way to go, boy.
I thought they were going to show ours this way.